Masters is, where is the love?
In 1687, Sir Isaac Newton discovered what was then known as the law of universal gravitation, gravity. Take two objects, the larger object exerts an attractive force on the smaller object, pulling it towards itself, as it were. An apple falls from a tree. The Earth, by far the more massive object, pulls the apple to the ground, simple enough. Only Newton's theory left scientists a rather puzzling problem. To paraphrase you, Dr. Farber, where is the gravity? It's not something you can see or touch. It's not something you can put under microscopes or examine from a telescope. Well, 230 years after Newton, a German patent clerk in Switzerland finally realized that scientists have been asking the wrong question all along. They would never find an object in all the immensity of space called gravity because, in point of fact, gravity is nothing but the shape of space itself. That clerk, Einstein, posited that the apple does not fall to the ground because the Earth exerts some mysterious kind of force upon it. The apple falls to the ground because it is following the lines and grooves that gravity has carved into space. When we talk about sex, we do not talk about love, Dr. Farber, because love cannot be rendered into columns and graphs as if it were the same as blood pressure or heart rate. Love is not a force exerted by one body onto another. It is the very fabric of those bodies. Love is that which carves the lines, curvature of our desires.